heart of the Congo Basin, in the furthest reaches of the rainforest. A handful of villagers are fighting for their lives to save a disappearing world from an unseen enemy. Rainforest of Central Africa. A vast green blanket covering an area the size of Mexico. It seems impossible that anybody could live in this impenetrable terrain, but they do. Hidden by trees are the forest homes of more than 3 million people. No one knows how long these people have lived in the rainforest. Ancient Egyptians recorded contact with them 2,500 years before the birth of Christ. Europeans who explored this region 4,000 years later called them pygmies. But they called themselves Baka, a word of unknown origin with just a ghost of a meaning. Free like a bird. The Baka believe they were thrown out of heaven for being too noisy and sent to live in the forest. Africa's huge rainforests straddle the equator. This corner of southeast Cameroon is part of the Central Congo Basin, a region with year-round heat and humidity. These are Africa's most ancient rainforests. This is the place the Baka call home. Semi-nomadic forest people, the Baka traditionally lived across huge territories, Then, in the 1960s, life changed. The Cameroonian government encouraged the Baka to move out of the forest. In return for settling in roadside villages, the Baka gained access to schools, medical care, and the chance to trade. It seemed like a good deal. For some, like Armand Bamiso, life in the village of Bosque offers the best of both worlds. Armand has lived in Bosque since the village first came together in 1972. He can't remember things any other way. But some can recall a time before the Red Dirt Highway. Like Jeanne Bejo. At 68, she's the oldest woman in Bosque. The surrounding trees are more than just a backdrop to village life. In all of the most important respects, the old ways still live on. Rainforest may look like the Garden of Eden, but it offers precious little in the way of food. There are more than 8,000 plant species in a Cameroonian forest. Most are inedible to all but the most specialized foragers. Black and white colobus monkeys feed mainly on leaves, foraging high up in the forest canopy. A low-grade food, this foliage doesn't offer much in the way of nutritional value. In order to survive, each colobus must eat a third of its own body weight in leaves each day. Feeding strategies have become so specialized that another primate living lower down in the very same tree eats in a completely different way. Mona monkeys spend most of their time near the ground, eating whatever they can find. The ingenuity needed to eke out a living here is most evident in our closest animal relatives, the great apes. Lowland gorillas are big animals. A group needs huge quantities of food, quantities that are hard to find in the forest. So gorillas must memorize when and where food can be found across great distances. That's one reason why lowland gorillas need at least 8 years of parental guidance before they can fend for themselves.